of them staring.
Say, you ain't seen Logan this evening, have you?
You mean Bert Logan, foreman of the Rogers Ranch?
Yeah, that's him.
No, I haven't.
I reckon I'll stick around and see if he comes in.
Who's there?
Steve.
Oh, come in.
Hi, Steve.
Who's downstairs?
Oh, the usual bunch.
Did you bring Logan with you?
No, but I brought Tula with me.
Tula? How many times have I told you to keep that woman away from here?
Oh, she's all right.
Oh, she's not all right. Listen, I'm going to make a few changes here.
Hello, Bert. I've been expecting you.
You would spoil my surprise. I'm glad to see you.
No, you're all wrong. You can't do it that way. Now listen to me.
You do as I tell you. And leave the rest to me.
Oh, all right.
Well, listen, you're taking a big chance.
Yes, but we gotta get this drill out of here.
I got some fast, Jack. I'll be back in about an hour.
All right. Come on,
give us another
one. Now, when did you say this happened?
About 3 months ago.
All right, Bert. I'll be seeing you in the morning.
Okay, Jim.
Rickard, you're the sheriff, and you've got to put a stop to this.
Bill's right, Lem. This night raiding must be ended. And it's up to you to do it.
Well, if either of you have anything to suggest, I'd be plenty happy. No one wants to stop this mysterious business any more than I do. All right.
I hope so.
Right amount, Dean. When do you want the saw delivered?
Hubbard! Don't make a false move!
That's a knife rider.
Bring that box over here!
This is George Burns talking, Sheriff. The night rider held me up.
What?
He just rode away.
Tell him he's headed north.
He's headed north.
All right, Burns, the posse will meet you.
All right, I'll wait here for you, but hurry.
The Night Rider's been at it again.
Night Rider?
Yes, you know where George Burns' place. Come on, let's go.
You the Night Rider?
Out here since early dawn. Don't you think you should go to your room and rest while I'm in town?
With what little time I have left, Barbara, I'm not going to spend half of it in bed.
Don't excite yourself, brother dear. You'll soon get well.
Don't worry about me, then.
Oh, but I can't help it, with that awful Night Rider coming and going whenever he pleases. Tula, would you ask Manuel to get my horse ready?
Yes, Senorita.
Isn't that Mr. Logan's horse, Steve?
Yes, ma'am.
Where's Logan?
Bert's been done for, Mr. Rogers.
How did it happen?
Don't know, but the Night Rider was at George Burns' place last night. This morning, I found Bert near the old mine, plugged through the heart.
Something must be done, Dan, about that awful creature. Why, no one is safe in this whole district.
I wish I had the use of my legs. I'd get him.
I know you would.
Listen, Barbara. I guess you'll have to go to town and see Jeff Barton and have him dig up a foreman for us.
You know, I don't like to talk to Barton any more than I have to.
I understand, Barbara. But he knows every available man in the district.
Oh, well, all right. Will you go with me, Steve? I'll be just a moment.
Yes, ma'am.
Tula, tú eres mi ilusión. Quiéreme.
¿Qué pasa? Señorita, it is I who wish to sing a song of love for you.
Tula.
Rapid, rapid.
¿Qué pasa?
Tula, she shall love only the bold, brave man. The man who do things.
But you speak to Manuel Alonso Valdez, he who shall be the bravest caballero in all the West.
You had better not speak so loud. Maybe the Night Rider is hearing you, and you not be so brave. Go now. Go get Miss Barbara her horse.
It is a big insult. So I'm no good, eh? I will show you. I will get the bold Night Rider. Myself, personal.
Caramba, no faltaba más que...
put the hands up. Your hands up. Hey. Put the hands up.
Get along there, you listen. What is it?
What's the matter? Are you deep? You know here? Put up the hands.
Huh? Get up, you listen.
Come on. Put up the hands.
Stop.
It is Manuel Alonso Valdez who orders it. Comprende?
How's that?
You have meet with the greatest caballero in all the West.
What? Oh, well, that's different.
Huh.
Yes, sir. Well, that's different. Are you sure this is the West? Cracky, I thought I was lost. Maybe you can tell me where I've been. You see, I come down here, right through that.
Aha. You are the bold night rider, no?
Yes, I've been riding nights. Days, too, for 3 months trying to...
It is a big insult. You know who it is I am. I'm the greatest caballero in all the West.
Hey, look out for that gun.
I know my gun.
Yes, sir. You certainly do know your gun.
Senor, you are my prisoner.
I ain't going to tell you again, young feller. Look out for that gun.
Andre, vamos.
Say, what you boys celebrating? What's all the shooting for?
Gracias, senor. It is a pleasure to meet with you. I just captured this man.
What's he been doing?
I think he is a night rider.
Oh-ho! Where are you from, stranger?
I'm from Altoona, Pennsylvania.
Altoona?
Yeah.
Say, did you ride that old curiosity out here?
Yeah. I had an awful time finding the West. Would you believe it? I rode through 5 states without seeing one road. Back home, when a fella takes a ride, he usually uses a road.
Say, stranger, how'd you come to run away from home, have a fight with your pap?
Well, a fella named Horace Greeley said go west and grow up in the country. I'm a little late, but I made her.
Well, now I'm right glad old Horace sent you out here. I'm glad to meet up with you. Hey, how do we know that you ain't the night rider?
Oh, no, senor. I am after him. It will mean more than 10,000 pesos. And besides, Manuel Alonso Valdez is loco with love.
So you're in love, huh, Alonso?
Si, senor.
Well, now ain't that nice. Say, maybe we could help you out.
Gracias.
No. I don't mean in the love business. I mean, capturing this here night rider.
Está bueno, señores. Then we can all be great caballeros and capture this man.
Well, I tell you, suppose we move over to my camp and talk things over. You fellas interfered with my grub.
We shall stick together and I shall be the brave capitão.
No. I think it's a better idea if we decide on who's going to be leader by shooting it out.
No, señor. I would not kill you or our friend Altoona.
You don't have to kill a fella every time you shoot a gun. I mean, shoot at a target. Got a gun, Altoona?
Yeah. Yes, he is.
Where'd you get that watch charm? Hey, you nursed that a while, it might grow up. Will it shoot?
I know, I never tried it. Where's your target?
All right, Cavallaro. You ready?
Hey. Keep your eye on it. might have been the man that would have killed him.
Go ahead, Al Tooney. Well, my shot.
Shall be our capitan. Me and Altoona, we shall be your lieutenant. No?
Are you with us, Altoona?
Yeah.
Come on.
I hope we find a road somewhere.
Hey, wait a minute. Let's get this stuff together here.
Well,
well, who might this drink be on?
It might be on the house.
Oh, well, that's different.
Barton.
Oh. Hey, what's this I hear about you forming a vigilante committee?
That's right. I am.
I don't care how far you go, as long as you keep within the law.
You'll have to admit, Sheriff, that you've fallen down on the job.
I won't admit a thing.
Whoa, you listen. Come on in, Altoona. Let's look things over.
Yeah.
It is understood, Capitan. We shall back each other up, no?
Straight across the board, Lieutenant.
Me too.
Hello, gents. Name is gents.
I'll have a little tequila.
Tequila?
Yeah.
Where'd you say you was from?
Altoona, Anthony. Why? Didn't I say tequila right?
Oh, he understood you all right. Here it is.
And of course, it's the same for Manuel Alonso Valdez.
Well, here you go, Lieutenant.
Well, look who's here. How's the great Caballero?
Fill him up again, no?
Nose right. Have him be damned.
Ernie, what's the art there?
You're from Altoona, Pennsylvania, huh?
Yeah.
Fill him up again, bartender.
Listen here, stranger. We don't stand for that kind of stuff around here.
Well, I've heard sheriffs talk that way before.
Well, this is one that means it. What's your business?
My business? Oh, I don't know. I rob banks, hold up trains, do a little second story work. Play the saxophone?
Well, you better come with me.
I haven't got anything to do right now. Say, you look terrible. Lieutenant, go buy old Al here a new outfit, will you?
Si, Capitan.
I'll see you after a while.
Si, senor.
Hey, lay off. No one can do that to me and get away with it.
You ought to feel lucky that Bad Jim Blake only used his fists.
Bad Jim Blake? The fastest gunman in the West? Was that him?
Yeah. He's the only man I ever heard of that wears two half-breed holsters.
Gee, I guess I was lucky.
I think we shall go and do what Capitan say, no?
Yeah. We're going to stay on the road, too.
Claro que si.
Glad to see you, John.
Thanks.
Who are you this time?
Then Jim Blake's guns you just took away from me?
Just right. He's never been in this town that I know of.
Well, he's sure visiting here now.
Oh, this is a pleasure, Miss Barbara. Steve just told me that you wanted to see me.
Yes, Dan said to ask you about a new foreman.
Oh, that's too bad. I mean about Bert Logan. He was a good man.
Yes.
I know the man you want. He just went over with the sheriff. Why don't you go over and talk with him yourself? His name is Jim Blake.
Why, thanks, I will. Please see if my horse is shod yet, Steve.
Yes, ma'am.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, Miss Barbara.
Say, what's the big idea?
Well, the sheriff can't hold him. And even if he does turn him loose, why, we may be able to use him a little later. Savvy?
Well, I'll be seeing you.
Huh?
All right, John. Oh, Jim, I mean.
Jim, that's it. Don't slip up on that Jim. So long.
We were just ready to make your rescue, Capitan. Maybe the sheriff, he is the night rider himself, no?
Well, now that's right fine. That's the stuff. One for all and all for one. Hey, why ain't you wearing that hat up, watching?
Everything's too big. This fella insisted on me taking it.
Let's see.
That way, though.
Why, Manuel, what are you doing here?
Ah, senorita, you shall meet the brave Capitan.
Hi, miss. My name is Blake. Jim Blake.
Why, you're the very man I came to meet. I'm Barbara Rogers. Mr. Barton sent me over to you, to see if you'd accept a position as foreman on our ranch.
Barton? Why, I don't know him, miss.
Oh, he runs a saloon over there, but my brother and I know him. We could pay you very well, Mr. Blake. Manuel knows us. He's worked for us quite a bit.
Yes, ma'am. Manuel is my first lieutenant. And this is my second lieutenant. He's a sort of a tourist. He's traveling out here for his health. He's from,
El Juni, in Slovenia.
Yes, sir. Well, suppose you take the two boys over to your place, and I'll go see this fellow Barton, and maybe I'll be out after a while.
Well, I do hope you can, Mr. Blake.
Thank you, ma'am.
He's the best shooter in all the West. He's quite a fella, ain't he? Well, guess we better get going.
He's a very gallant caballero.
Well, partner, on?
Yeah, it's over there.
That's me, Blake.
How are you?
Oh, excuse me for not shaking hands.
Oh, I understand. Kind of slows up your draw, doesn't it? Say, I've heard a lot about you.
Yeah, you have been taking quite an interest in me lately, ain't you? Asked that little girl to give me a job and everything.
Well, I thought maybe Miss Barbara might free you from the sheriff.
Oh, I don't have much trouble with sheriffs. They keep away from me pretty good.
Oh, I understand. I kind of like Miss Barbara myself. She just asked me about a new foreman, and I thought of you.
Okay.
Pardon me. Say, that Rogers Ranch would be a pretty good place, I imagine, for you to rest up and sit and get your bearings.
Well, I'm sure much obliged to you. I may take a ride over tomorrow.
All right. Have a little drink?
No, thanks. I got to run along.
All right. See you a little later. Say, bring a couple of drinks over to the table, will you?
Righto.
Out to the ranch?
Yeah, he was asleep in the bunkhouse when I left.
But it's our business to cover up the chief.
on around here. The bank's been robbed, Sheriff.
Well, I saw them go that way. Come on, vigilantes.
Oh, wait a minute, Clinton. Where's the horse? I gotta go.
Steve, let Little Ricker have your horse. Might make a hit with Dan Rogers.
All right.
What's all this racket about?
Someone just came in here, Mr. Rogers.
Who are you?
I'm Jim Blake.
I heard voices, Dan. What's happened?
Miss Barbara, I was following the night rider and I think he came in here.
Oh, it's you, Mr. Blake.
Yes, ma'am.
Let him in. Search the place, Barbara.
Go around the back door. That leads to Dan's room.
Who's in there?
Tulis.
Let's go in.
Come in. What's the matter?
I'm sorry, Mr. Bust in on you this way.
You frightened me.
Oh, don't be frightened. Mr. Blake thought he heard someone getting into the house. Did you hear anything?
No, I don't hear nothing.
Oh, I think I'd better go see how Dan is. He's probably awfully upset. Are you all right, dear?
Where did that man go?
I don't know. Mr. Blake is looking for him.
No, I mean Blake himself. How do we know he isn't trying to rob us?
Oh, now, Dan, calm yourself. I'll go out and see what he's doing.
Oh, he got away, miss. I'm going to have another look around outside.
All right, good night, Mr. Blake, and thanks so much for your kindness.
Good night.
Logan's body was found here.
Oh. What's that over yonder, miss?
Oh, it used to be the old Rogers mine.
I see they ain't working it now.
No, it's been abandoned for several years, though Dan wanted to reopen it. His accident happened there, and my father was killed in the explosion.
Oh, I'm sorry, miss. When did that happen?
About 3 months ago. I wasn't out west then. I promised Dan not to go near it. He's afraid there might be some dynamite left under the cave-in.
Oh. Would you mind if I went over and had a look at it, miss?
Oh, of course not, if you're not afraid. I'll ride on to the house. It's not far from here.
All right, miss. I'll meet you there directly.
Barbara.
Yes, senor.
Is that fellow Blake? Has Barbara returned yet?
No, senor.
Oh, never mind. I'm all right.
Hello, Dan.
Where's Blake?
He's the most interesting man I've ever met.
When is he?
He went to look at the old mine. Oh, now, Dan, don't be angry. I told him about my promise to you and about the dynamite, but he wanted to see for himself. Now, I'll be back in just a minute, as soon as I change these clothes.
A lieutenant of the brave Capitan like you should have a better horse.
He stuck to me, I'll stick to him.
Ah, no, see, Mr. Caballo. Ah, look. The Capitan has got a beautiful one. Someday, maybe Manuel will own one like that, no? Anda, gente.
Well, I see Sonny come in himself, huh?
Walked in alone.
Hey, did you go to town, do as I told you?
Yeah, that's why I'm fixing Ulysses up. His feet got a bit sore.
Oh, you did find a road then, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, Capitan, Senor Rogers, he looked for you.
Where is he?
At the veranda with Miss Barber and that Tula.
Wonder what he wants of him.
Quien sabe, maybe we get fired.
And that's all right with me.
When and then we go away, you don't have to work no more.
Yeah.
Hello, Sheriff. What do you want? I should think you'd spend your time looking for the night rider.
Guess what I'm doing. Where's Blake, your foreman?
Are you looking for me, Sheriff?
It's just about far enough, Blake. Take his gun. Blake.
Trouble?
A man named Roy Jones accuses Blake here of being the night rider. And this piece of paper proves that he is.
I'm
sure sorry, Mr. Rogers. I caused you all this trouble. You've been sick and ailing. Miss, you just made a mistake in trusting me. I'm right sorry I disappointed you.
Too bad, Blake.
Got that handwriting copy pretty good, ain't it, Lim?
You sure have.
Senor Altoni, I don't like this.
Oh, what ails you? Everything's gonna be all right.
I hate to do this, Lim. Can you breathe?
Yeah.
That's too bad. That's the seal. It's what the old boy puts on all his documents. That ought to fix it.
You're the boss.
What's that? I'm the chief. I better go out the back way here in the alley, huh? Won't be long now.
Against
Adam. Didn't Al Juni tell you that I ain't the night rider?
Senor Altoni, he not told me nothing, but I go with the Capitan to the end.
All right, let's go. To the end. Now, where are you going?
I'm going inside, Capitan.
You're going with me.
No, Capitan.
Come on.
Hello, good looking.
Listen, you wait here until I come back, see?
No, Capitan, take me with you.
You're a fine lieutenant, you are. Put yourself together.
All right. Two whiskeys. Bottle of vodka.
Afraid of going and scratched up your desk. See, I come in to borrow a pencil and paper.
Tell you not to be too hasty?
Why, hello, Steve. I'm glad to see you back again. Barton, you know who your chief is.
reckon I can trust you, eh, Barton? Sure, Chief. You know I've always done as I was told.
Well, we've got to get it going before somebody gets over there and finds the sheriff and turns him loose. The girl is yours. I'll see you tonight.
Now, come on.
I'm one of the first lieutenants. See you later, boys.
I suppose he expects us to release the sheriff.
Well, that's the chief's handwriting, all right. And I, for one, am glad that this business of working for somebody that you don't even know is over with.
If he's the chief.
Well, his stamp proves it, Steve.
Yeah?
Okay.
Now listen, Lieutenant. I'm going to leave you behind this time, see? You stay here and watch, and when the sheriff's released, you tell him to get a posse together and be at the Rogers Ranch at midnight. Savvy?
Si, senor.
Come on.
Is you who make fun of the great Manuel Alonso Valdez, no?
You think you're brave, eh? Just because you have a gun on a lady. One time, not long ago, you make love to me, no?
Quédate.
Do you realize what this means if you're caught?
Well, I ought to. But I've got to take a chance.
The law punishes a crime like this with death. You must be crazy.
I'm sorry, Miss Barbara.
Don't you dare call me Barbara.
Is that you, Barton?
Here we are, Chief.
Well, I see you followed my orders.
Yes, Chief.
You take this lady back to the ranch. I'll meet you there later with the money. I have a little score to settle with Rogers.
Yes, Chief.
Stop reading that thing, I'll be as crazy as you are.
Try to give up, boys. You're surrounded.
Why, it's a plant.
No, it's not a plant, Bart.
Get up.
It's the law you laughed at.
Down the hallway, quick.
See you that way, quick.
Worry now, everything's gonna be all right. Dan never was much good, John. He poisoned his mind with them crime stories and it drove him half crazy.
Yeah, that's the way I figured it. That's the reason he did away with Barbara's father and pretended to be a cripple.
Yeah. After my brother was killed, I come out to do a little investigating. Meeting you made it easy, John.
Well, thank you, Aunt Julie.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
The sheriff told me you're an officer of the law, Mr. Brown.
Why, yes, ma'am. I'm sure sorry, Miss Barbara, things turned out as they did.
Poor Dan. And what are your plans?
Oh, I figured on moseying along.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was hoping you could stay on as foreman.
Well, I tell you, miss, when I take a job of that kind, I usually like to be the only boss.
Well, all right. You can be boss then.
Well, all right. I reckon I'll stay then.
And still you'll be our brave capitan.
You're still our lieutenant, ain't you?
Si, senor.
Well, tell you what you do. Suppose you go on out and curry Altoony's mule.
Si, senor.
Well, what are you going to do?
Oh, I don't know. I thought I'd take a little trip back to Altoony, Pennsylvania.
You're going back on that white mule?
Yes.
You'll never make her. All right, I guess I'll stick along. Barbara.
Thanks, John.